When I first met Miriam, it had been 262 days since her concussion. 262 days since she'd been able to run and jump with her three-year-old son. 262 days of constant pulsating headaches. It had been 262 days since she'd been able to read a book, watch a movie, or go to work. Miriam's life had completely changed when she slipped on a patch of ice while out walking her dog. She told me that she felt overwhelmed and that there were many days when she looked in the mirror and just didn't recognize herself. She was grieving the loss of the person that she used to be. The healthcare professionals that Miriam saw early after her fall had told her, "This is a concussion, but don't worry. You'll feel better in the coming weeks and months." So every day, for 262 days, Miriam woke up hoping that today would be the day that she would feel better. But after more than 9 months of ongoing symptoms, she was sure that something must be terribly wrong with her. In my work as a physiatrist with the Acquired Brain Injury Program at Parkwood Institute, I see many people like Miriam who haven't followed the expected course of recovery after their concussion. And I'm going to pause here for just a moment because I bet some of you are wondering, what's a physiatrist? I'm a medical doctor who develops non-surgical, patient-centered treatment plans with a focus on function. And I work as part of a team with other healthcare practitioners to oversee the course of rehabilitation for my patients. Physiatrists get to work with a wide variety of different types of patients, but my own personal area of interest and focus is on acquired brain injury and concussion. Now, let's get back to Miriam. She was feeling frustrated with the advice that she'd been given early after her fall. Based on that advice, she had made plans and set expectations for herself. She had expected that she would be back to work and back to life within a couple of months at the most. But days, weeks, and months went by, and she was starting to worry that this wasn't going to be the case for her. Now, I want to be clear here. The advice that Miriam was given after her fall was not wrong. The Ontario Neurotrauma Foundation guidelines recommend that after a first concussion, people should be offered reassurance and told to expect a full recovery within 3 months. This advice is very appropriate for the large majority of people after concussion, but 20% of people will still have symptoms after 3 months. The guidelines also recommend that any person who isn't following the expected course of recovery or who has risk factors for persistent symptoms be referred to a specialized concussion clinic. And as someone who works in one of those clinics, one of the most common questions I get asked is, when will I be better? Unfortunately, that's a very difficult question to answer, and I don't have a crystal ball. But what would concussion care be like if I did? Scientists have been able to identify a number of factors that when present, increase the risk for persistent symptoms after concussion. But there is still so much that we don't know. We don't know which of these factors are the most important. We also don't know what happens when more than one of these factors is present in the same person at the same time. As a researcher at Western University, I am working to develop a tool, like a calculator, that can accurately predict time to recovery after concussion. This is the kind of information that we need to have up front, right when someone first presents for care after their injury. This is that crystal ball. When clinicians know which patients are at high risk of persistent symptoms after their injury, they can prioritize these individuals for specialized rehabilitation. And when patients know their projected time to recovery and risk level, they will know what to expect and can better plan for return to school, return to work, return to play, and return to life. I believe that if we can deliver the right care to the right person at the right time, that we can potentially change their course of recovery and help them recover more like someone without risk factors. I typically see people who are months or even years out from their injury. So I am working together with healthcare practitioners who routinely see people immediately after their injury. This project is bringing together scientists and healthcare professionals from across the spectrum of concussion care. Because when we work together, we are better able to support members of our community like Miriam, so that hopefully there is a future where nobody has to wake up every day for 262 days with questions like, what's wrong with me? Where can I go for help? And when will I be better? Thank you.